Hey everyone, it's Sarah here from gluten-free and dairy-free at Walt Disney World. Today we're going to take a trip to the West Coast and do a brief review of lunch at Cafe Orleans in Disneyland in Anaheim, California. So let's take a stroll down New Orleans Square and take a look at the special dietary needs options available at Cafe Orleans. Opening in New Orleans Square in 1966, Cafe Orleans, which used to be called the Creole Cafe, has been a longtime favorite of Disney guests for its authentic New Orleans-inspired meals and its connection to Walt Disney. In fact, if you visit Cafe Orleans, you'll see a vintage espresso maker purchased by Walt and Lillian Disney while they were on vacation in Italy. Cafe Orleans has changed from a quick service to a table service restaurant over the years and has been a table service dining location since 2006. Its current meal offerings include lunch and dinner, both serving up meals with French Quarter flair. The interior of Cafe Orleans includes dark wood, brass fixtures, and stained glass, all of which will transport you back in time. If you enjoy eating al fresco, ask for a seat out on Cafe Orleans' cozy patio area with covered tables. It's the perfect way to enjoy a meal and watch the hustle and bustle in New Orleans Square. Of course, no matter where you sit, you're sure to soak in some of that New Orleans charm. Like many restaurants at Disneyland, guests with special dietary needs will be served an allergy-friendly menu. At many other locations, guests with special dietary needs can speak directly to a chef about options. However, when we visited Cafe Orleans, we were advised that we could not at that time, and then a manager would assist us with any questions that we had. So, guests with special dietary needs may have mixed results when asking to consult with a member of the culinary team at Cafe Orleans. Cafe Orleans does have a slightly limited menu, in our opinion. For starters, guests who are gluten-free will want to try out the house salad with baby greens and a raspberry vinaigrette with cherry tomatoes, crumbled goat cheese, and candied pecans. For those guests who are also dairy-free, this could be made safe by omitting the cheese. Although this wasn't our personal favorite salad, it's a good option for those who like a salad with a bit of a sweeter flavor. Guests who are gluten-free will have many different entree options, including muffuletta chopped salad, shrimp and grits, black and sustainable fish, which is also dairy-free, and steak and potatoes to name a few. We do recommend that prior to ordering that you do confirm that a dish is safe for your special dietary need, as we noticed several dishes that were marked safe for a specific dietary need but actually contained the allergen or ingredient in the dish. For instance, we noted dishes marked as milk-free that contained cheese and a dish that was marked gluten-free but contained a beer molasses sauce. So it's always good to double-check prior to ordering to ensure that your meal is both safe and delicious. Now, one of the most popular items that can be made gluten-free with advance notice, but is not listed on the allergy-friendly menu, is the Cafe Orleans Monte Cristo. We were advised by Disneyland's Special Dietary Needs Department to give them 2 weeks advance notice of our request and to speak with cast members at the restaurant upon arrival. Unfortunately, we did not find our experience to be a particularly good one, even with advance notice. When we arrived, we notified our server about our pre-order, but the restaurant did not have our information, and we were advised that they couldn't accommodate making the gluten-free Monte Cristo. Well, thanks to the kindness of one of the managers on duty at Cafe Orleans, we were able to get the sandwich, but we did have to wait a bit for our order. Now, did the Monte Cristo live up to the hype? Well, it definitely did. We were really impressed by the flavors of the gluten-free Monte Cristo, which is a deep-fried and powdered sugar-covered sandwich filled with turkey, ham, and Swiss, and served with a side of berry puree. The combination might sound a bit odd, but the flavors are so outstanding. The gluten-free version is made using cup-for-cup gluten-free flour and Udi's gluten-free bread. Now, this is a dish we could eat again and again. As we later learned at the end of our meal, the restaurant actually received the wrong date from Disneyland Special Diets about our visit and our request for the Monte Cristo. And while our Monte Cristo was truly outstanding, we felt the way that the restaurant handled the situation made the experience less than magical. So much so that I think we would have to seriously consider eating at Cafe Orleans again, something we've never said about any Disney restaurant. Our biggest recommendation for those guests who want the gluten-free Monte Cristo is to not only pre-order with Disneyland's special diets department, but to also stop by the restaurant the day before or the morning before you dine there to ensure that they have your pre-order. We've heard from multiple Disneyland guests who had a similar experience to ours and recommend double-checking before dining here. Overall, Cafe Orleans has a vintage charm and a vibe that make it a wonderful restaurant to dine in. Add in a decadent gluten-free Monte Cristo, and you have an authentic and delicious meal. But of course, with some pre-trip planning, anyone interested in the sandwich can enjoy it. For those guests interested in other items on the Cafe Orleans menu, you'll find plenty to choose from too. If you want more information about Cafe Orleans, check out the review on my blog, as well as a review from my friend Alexis at Alexis's Gluten-Free Adventures, and we'll link to those in the show notes. And if you've dined at Cafe Orleans and tried that gluten-free Monte Cristo, let us know. Share your experience with us in the comment section. And of course, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a like and subscribe to the channel for more food and theme park videos. If you want to help support gluten-free and dairy-free at Walt Disney World, you can do so by becoming a patron on Patreon too. For now, thanks for listening, and we'll see you with another Disney video real soon.